Hey guys, you are with the Tech Science. Today we have to discuss a new point, and the name of the point is Mendel's principle of heredity. And in the Mendel's principle of heredity, we have the different points are there. Generally, this point is from the chapter Heredity and Variation from the class 9th. It is applicable for 11th also, 12th also, because in the field of biology, Mendel having a very good importance, a very important topic that has been put forth by the Mendelus. Actually, we use the word like law of inheritance. Instead of laws, we use the word postulates that has been put forth by the Mendelius, not the laws. Later on, the three scientists work on that, we know already. And afterward, the law of dominance, this is the first law, law of segregation, and law of assortment, independent assortment. So these are the different types of laws that has been put forth by the scientists. So here, the different laws are there, that laws has been put forth. For this law of dominance, we have this monohybrid cross. Before that, what exactly the theme behind working of this monohybrid and hybrid cross, we must know that. Here we know that the genetic material that is transferred in equal quantity from parent to the offspring, also called as a progeny. So we know that this is what the main theme, and principle of heredity is based on this fact only. What is the fact? Genetic material is transferred in equal quantity from parent to progeny. So this is what the this is what the fact, right? So this is called the fact of principle of heredity. Now, if both the parents, which makes an equal contribution in transferring the characteristics of heredity. Now, question is what? When the parents make an equal contribution, now which characteristics will be appear first in the progeny? And for the reason, Mendel performed a lot of experiment on the plant Pisum sativum, also called as the pea plant. Now, this pea plant, for this reason, the Mendeleev considered the number of characteristics like shape of the seed, color of the seed, color of the flower, shape of the pod, then height of the plant, then position of the flower, etc. So number of characteristics are there. Out of that, if you work on a single characteristics, then it is called as the monohybrid cross. Let's see, we are taking an example, height of the plant. Regarding height of the plant, we have the two different types of characteristics are there. One pea plant is completely tall, and second pea plant is completely dwarf. Dwarf stand for it is a short plant. Now, question is arising in the mind of Mendel, whether when we cross in between the tall and the dwarf plant, what should be the progeny or the new plant that is called hybrid plant, which is generated from crossing in between these two. It may be tall, it may be short, or it may be a medium size. So expectation beyond the considered by the Mendeleev, but here the result is somewhat different. Now question is what? What is the Mendeleev's Mendel's the laws of inheritance on the basis of, first, it is called monohybrid cross. So let's see what is the monohybrid cross is there. So we have the only one pair of contrasting character, and here we consider height is a contrasting character that we have to discuss here. So we have, first it is called tall plant, and second is called the dwarf plant. Second is dwarf plant. As we know that the genes are always present in the pair. So for the reason, capital T and capital T, here we consider as a tall, and small t, it is considered as a dwarf plant, as it is diploid in nature. Now, whenever the gametes, we are discussing about the gametes, gametes are always haploid. For the reason, we can consider capital T is a gamete from the tall, and small t, it is one of the gametes from the dwarf. Am I right? So, whenever there is a cross in between these two, what happened here? This capital T here and this capital T is here. So, here the new plant that is made by crossing these two, so it is tall in nature. How it is found? It is tall in nature. This is somewhat the shocking result for the Mendels, and this is called the first generation, first filial generation. So, when there is a crossing in between the tall plant versus dwarf plant, so new plant will be appear here, the progeny will be appear here, and in this progeny, one of the characteristics is from the tall and second is from the dwarf. Out of that, which is seen by the eyes, it is called phenotype. So what is the phenotype? It is tall in nature. And that's why capital T, it is considered as a dominant characteristics, means tallness is a dominant characteristics, and small t stand for dwarf, it is a recessive characteristics. It is a recessive characteristics. So this is what the tall plant after the crossing in between these two. But there is a difference in between this tall and this tall. If you observe, it is an original tall plant which is having the homozygous and it is completely heterozygous. So it having the different genes in the tallness, whether it having the different. Now, what happened here? Next time, the Mendel cross the tall plant, hybrid tall plant. So in between that, he considered the two tall plants from the first generation. The first one is called male and second is called the female. And in between these, that is called capital T, small t. And here also capital T and the small t. Again, there is a crossing in between the tall plant, which is appear in the first filial generation. Let's see what happened here. Now observe. So here, when there is a crossing in between these two. So observe. So this is what the second generation is called, F2 generation. So the first is called male and second is called the female. If you separate this, like gametes, so first gamete is capital T and second gamete is small t, and here also the first gamete is capital T and second gamete is small t. Now when you cross in between these plants, now what happened here? Observe, there is a formation of capital T, capital T, second capital T, small t, third capital T, small t, and last small t, small t. If this is what the second, it is called the second generation, F2, second filial generation. Okay, it is called F2 generation. So in F2 generation, what you found exactly, we have the two different types of ratios are there. The first is called phenotype ratio and second is called genotype ratio. What is meaning of the word phenotype ratio? Phenotype ratio means the ratio which can be seen by our naked eyes. Observe, capital T, capital T stand for tall plant. Capital T, small t also tall plant. This is also tall plant. Means here three plants are tall in the second generation. And small t stand for dwarf. So one plant is completely dwarf. So this is what the ratio 3:1, that what we are seeing our eyes. It is called phenotype ratio. What about the genotype ratio, which is based on the genes? The genes having the three possibilities. First, capital T, capital T. Second, capital T, small t. It is homozygous tall, it is heterozygous tall. And last is called small t, small t. So if you observe, capital T, capital T, it is only one plant. Second, capital T, small t, we have the two plants. And last, small t, having only one plant. So what is genotype ratio? 1:2, 2:1. This is what the genotype ratio, which is found in the second generation, F2 generation. While there is a crossing between male and the female plant of the F1 generation, that is also a tall plant. But here, some of the characteristics are dominant and some of the recessive are there. In next generation, recessive also seen as well as dominant also seen. So this is what the point, it is called the Mendel's monohybrid cross. I hope you understand the video. If you like the video, please subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon for the new notification. Thank you.